Random House Audio presents Nnnnn by Carl Reiner. Read for you by the author. Chapter 1. An eon ago. My dear brother, I cannot believe what thou art telling me. I did see her. Art thou certain it was not our mother thou didst see? It was not our mother. But thou hast said that she had the look of mama, in that she had large breasts and no penis or testicles. Thou hast described mama. No, she hath skin darker than mama's. Cain, thou dost not wish to lie with mama, dost thou? I do not, Abel. Data said thou must if thou art to multiply. Then I choose not to multiply. Cain, where didst thou see this creature? On the other side of the steep hill, lapping water from a stream. Cain, we are forbidden to leave our garden. Why hast thou disobeyed Dada? To find what lies outside of Eden. And there I did see her. I thought it was Mama, and that she had been rolling in mud. Mama enjoys to roll in mud. But when I called Mama, she ran off on legs that were thinner and longer than Mama's. It was the dark woman. It was Mama. Abel, my penis erected. That had ne'er happened whilst looking at Mama. This morning she drank again from the stream, and in the sunlight I could see no mud on her dark skin. Cain, Abel scolded, there are but 4 humans in the world, and they are all of one color. This is a known fact, a universal truth. And now, Abel, with my new known fact, we have a new universal truth. There are more than 4 humans in the world, and the dark woman did say, many more than 4. And Cain, Abel scoffed, how many more does this dark creature who does not exist say there are in the world? 19. 19? I know of no such word. Nor did I, until she showed me 19, Cain said, opening his hand to show many shiny black stones. See, Cain explained, placing 4 stones on the ground. This is how many humans are in our garden. And here, Cain placed the remaining agates in Abel's hand, is how many more there are in the world. I see stones, Abel said. I do not see humans. Thou art pig-headed, Cain roared. Canst thou not accept that one of the stones in thy hand represents one human? I could, if there were a human to be represented by it. There is, Cain shouted, grabbing a stone from his brother's hand. This is that human woman, and I did see her. Does this stone, Abel said, smirking, have a name? I know it not, but I will learn it, Cain said, caressing the stone, and I will find her. Thou hast seen no person, Abel argued. You dreamed her. Did I dream these? Cain shouted, displaying the stones. Thou didst gather them while asleep. I have seen thee walk, talk, and pee in thy sleep. Cain, did thou inform Dada of this dark woman? No, Dada thinks there are but 4 of us in the world. Dada does not think, Abel shouted. Dada knows. Does Dada know from whence we came? From Mama's vagina. Dada told thee. Abel, I know not because Dada told me, but because I did see thee come out of Mama. But from whence did Mama come? From Dada's rib, Abel insisted. Dada hath told us many times. And I do not believe it, because I did not see Mama come from Dada's rib. So, from whence dost thou think Mama came? I do not know. And didst thou not wonder who made Dada? No, Cain. Dada made himself from his own rib. Dada is a self-made man. He hath told thee that. Did Dada tell thee how he did arrive in the garden? Abel smirked again. Cain, Dada did not have to arrive in the garden, for Dada was already here. Cain sighed and ran off toward the hill. Cain, Where goest thou? To find her and ask her name, Cain shouted, holding the stone aloft, and to ask if she will lie with me. She doth not exist, Cain. She is but a dream. Yes, a dream, and she doth exist, Cain shouted, his voice trailing as he left the Garden of Eden. She exists! She exists!
That is page 4, Nat Nolan mumbled as he checked the page count on his computer screen. Good start, he said, smiling. 20 more and we can title this baby. Experience told Nat that if he wrote 24 acceptable pages, a full novel would follow. N, for novel, had been the working title of his first novel. NN, his second, and this being his fifth, Nat typed NNNNN into the computer. Being borderline superstitious and aware that his first published novel, Normal, started with an N and had been a minor success, he decided that all of his titles would contain a word that began with an N. You know something, Nat, my boy, he told himself, looking at the five N's atop the page. NNNNN could be the title. Yeah, it has an element of mystery, Nat agreed, like M, that classic German film by Fritz Lang. With Peter Lorre, Nat added excitedly. One of the all-time great titles. That single letter M was intriguing. Five N's would be five times as intriguing, Nat said. Could I justify using all five?
Five N's, Nat whined. I don't think so.
How about No, 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 Nanette? That was the title of a musical, schmucko. That was No, No, Nanette, Nat joked. This has three more no's. And don't call me schmucko. Hey, about this book, he said, grimacing. Do I really want to do my version of Genesis? That was the idea. A little blasphemous, don't you think? A little blasphemy is good. It's provocative, and provocative sells. Not always. Not, darling, said a soft soprano voice wafting down the stairwell. You're talking to yourself again. Oh, damn, really? Really, and rather loudly. Glennie answered, balancing a mug on a small tray. Weren't you aware of it? I'm not sure. I think I was. Shit, no, I wasn't, Glennie. Could you hear what I was saying? Something about blasphemy, she said, making her way down the stairs. And you told yourself not to call you schmucko.
Oh, boy.
I'm sorry, darling, she said, setting the tray down. But you did want me to tell you when you're having these conversations. Yes, yes. Damn, I thought I was thinking those things. Clunny, I'm getting to be a weirdo. Darling, lots of people talk to themselves. Yeah, and whenever I see one, I say to myself, there goes a weirdo. I hope I'm saying it to myself. Did you ever hear me say that? Never. Drink your postum, darling, while it's hot. You know, Nat announced, picking up the oversized mug, a lot of people think I'm weird for drinking postum. I drink it. Yeah, but you don't talk to yourself, he said, sipping from his mug. I'm definitely a weirdo. I'm even writing weirdly. How is your novel coming, darling? She asked brightly, hoping to buoy his spirits. It's not, he said, taking two short sips. Not coming? It's coming, but I'm not sure it's a novel. What is it, then? I don't know, but whatever it is, it's flying out of me. I know one thing, though. It's going to disappoint my publisher. And the people he likes to call my loyal readers. Nat, would you like me to read it? No, it's only 4 pages, and I don't need you to be disappointed, too. I have a feeling I won't be, but if you think... I do. It's like nothing I've ever written. The subject, the style, the font.
The font?
Yeah, instead of Times New Roman, I'm using monotype cursiva. Never used that before. Crazy, huh?
Monotype cursiva? No, that's wonderful, darling, Glennie gushed, clueless as to what monotype cursiva looked like. You have been grousing about repeating yourself.
No, Glennie.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.